this video, I'm going to be showing you 8 of the best VHLS algorithms. VHLS stands for Vandenberg-Harris last slot, and you can use it when you've done most of your F12, and you can finish it in 3 moves. So if you have a pair like this, or if you have a split pair like this. If you don't include the mirrors, there's really only 14 cases you need to learn, but I'll show you these 8 because they're the ones that I think will actually help you in solves. What VHLS does is, instead of you just inserting the pair and being able to get any OLL, you do a certain algorithm so that when you insert the pair, all the last layer edges are oriented. This means you can only get one of the 7 OLL cases where only the corners are misoriented. So generally these cases are a lot better than other OLLs, and you'll avoid getting bad dot cases like this. It also makes you 8 times more likely to get an OLL skip. Most people already know this first case I'm going to be showing. It's called sledgehammer, and you use it when you've got this L of oriented edges that's on the back and left when you put your block in the front right position. You don't need to worry about where the corners are in VHLS because it's only to orient the edges. So all you have to do is R prime, F, R, F prime. And you see that solves or orients all the last layer edges. This next case is similar, but when you put the connected pair in the front right position, your L shape is on the front left. So what you do, there are 2 ways I'm going to show you to do this. First is to do Y, and then do U, F, and then an insertion, so R, U prime, R prime, F prime. The second way that I would usually do is to do a YD, so a U and a Y prime. So you've got the slot in the back here, and then the connected pair here, and do R2 prime, F, R, F prime, R. In this case, you've got your pair not connected, and you've just got one edge oriented, which will be in the front if you've got the pair here. So what you do is R, U2, and then rotate, so Y, and then do your basic insertion, R, U prime, R prime, F prime. In this case, when you've got the connected pair at the front right, you'll have a line of oriented edges going from front to back. So what you do is you put the connected pair in the front left position and do F prime, L prime, U prime, L, F. This case is one where you're dealing with a pair that isn't connected, so one that you would insert with R, U, R prime. So if this corner is at the front right, then you'll have a line of oriented edges going from left to right. And what you do is you kind of pretend you're inserting a pair here to start off with. So R, U prime, R prime, U2, and then just do a sledgehammer. R prime, F, R, F prime. This one is a very similar algorithm to the last one. Here, instead of having a bar going across there, you've got an L with the pieces at the right and the front. And instead of starting off with an R, U prime, R prime, you start off with an R, U2, R prime. And then just do a U prime, then sledgehammer. R prime, F, R, F prime. In this case, only one edge is oriented, and that edge is on the left when your connected pair is at the front right. So what you do is you basically start off with a sledgehammer, so R prime, F, R, F prime, but instead of doing that last move, you cancel straight into an F sexy, R, U, R prime, U prime, F prime algorithm. So overall, it looks like this. R prime, F, R2, U, R prime, U prime, F prime. This is the last one I'm going to show. It's a connected pair case, and you don't have any edges oriented at all. So, I only learned this when I was preparing for this video. It's quite an interesting case. It looks like there's not much you can do, but what you do is you do a Y move. So you've got the piece here and your slot on the left, and do R prime, F prime, R to get this edge piece out and insert the pair. Then do U2, M prime, U prime, N. So that inserts the edge and you've got all your last layer edges oriented. For some people, you might think that is M, but generally that's meant to be an M move, so that's the notation I've used. Well, thanks for watching that. If you want to learn the rest of VHLS and you've learned all these cases, then it's pretty easy to find algorithms on the internet. So just look at them and see if you think they're worth learning and they'll actually make you any faster. But hopefully you've looked at these algs and you want to learn them now. Thanks for watching.